Please get ready for dictation of exercise number 18 from legal material. 5 seconds. Start. The trial court, on the basis of medical evidence, held that death of Seema was homicidal. As to the culpability of the accused for an offence under section 302, the court held that in the light of the evidence of father and mother of deceased Seema, it was clearly established that the appellant mother-in-law of the deceased was harassing Seema. The trial court also observed that it was true that in the first dying declaration, the deceased did not involve her mother-in-law, but it was because of the fact that she was asked by her mother-in-law not to implicate any member of the family of the appellant. The trial court noted that after the first dying declaration was recorded, the parents and inmates of deceased Seema had reached the hospital. The deceased could get courage to state true facts, and again the special judicial magistrate was called and the second dying declaration was recorded, in which she disclosed true and correct facts. The trial court also noted that the special judicial magistrate was conscious of the fact that in the first dying declaration she had not involved any family members of her in-laws. A specific question was therefore put by him as to the reason why she had done so, and the deceased had replied that it was because of her mother-in-law who asked the deceased to do so. The trial court therefore held the conduct of deceased Seema as natural and the second dying declaration reliable, which could be treated as basis for holding the appellant guilty. The trial court also observed that from the evidence of PW2, father of the deceased, and PW3, mother of the deceased, it was proved that Seema was ill-treated by her in-laws, and particularly the appellant mother-in-law. The court also observed that PW5 had no axe to grind against the appellant. PW5 stated that on being questioned, Seema stated that she was burnt by her mother-in-law by throwing burning kerosene lamp on her, but she had not stated so in the previous dying declaration because of the insistence of her mother-in-law. On the basis of evidence of parents of deceased, the trial court convicted the appellant. The learned counsel for the appellant contended that both the courts have committed an error of law in relying upon the second dying declaration. It was contended that the first dying declaration was correct and the deceased had stated true facts in the said declaration. It was also stated that after parents of the deceased had come to the hospital, they had persuaded the deceased to involve and implicate the appellant, and that is how the second dying declaration was recorded, which could not have been relied upon, and no motive was established by the prosecution. It was therefore submitted that the appeal deserves to be allowed by setting aside the order passed by the trial court and confirmed by the High Court. The public prosecutor for the state, on the other hand, supported the order of conviction and sentence passed by the trial court and confirmed by the High Court. He submitted that the conduct of the deceased Seema was natural, which was believed by both the courts. It was obvious that on August 13, 1998, she was pressurized by her mother-in-law for not giving name of her assailant. Moreover, she was surrounded by her in-laws and nobody from her parental family was present. It was only after her family members had come that she got courage to narrate true facts, and that is how on August 14, 1998, second dying declaration was given by her, which inspired confidence and both the courts believed it. It was also submitted that from the evidence of parents of the deceased, it was clearly proved that she was ill-treated and was frequently beaten by the appellant. Instances were also cited which went to show that the appellant was cruel to the deceased. The counsel also stated that both the courts were right in observing that special judicial magistrate was an independent witness, and when on the basis of his evidence a finding of guilt of the appellant was recorded, no interference is called for. Stop.